kingdom of the Magyar. King István, Rétha Kanti, his brother, Duke Vasa, desired the throne, so mounted a rebellion against István. Defending himself in a fierce battle, István defeated Vasa. In true Magyar tradition, Vasa's eyes were gouged out and molten lead poured into his ears.
Sounds fair.
His three sons, Bela, Andrew, and Levente, were exiled from Hungary. But there was unhappiness in Hungary, and the three princes were begged to return. A rebellion began, and war once again came upon the land. The king, Peter, was arrested and blinded. Andrew succeeded to the throne. The Magyar celebrated their new king. Majestic were our lands once again. But the crown of the Magyar is a great burden. King Andrew's brother, Bela, desired the throne for himself. King Andrew refused to renounce the throne. He and his queen, Anastasia, knew their army was strong and God was on their side. Bela, who was a general in the Polish army, entered Hungary under the cloak of night to meet with those who supported his bid for the throne. They met in the castle, Holbiko, near the town of Sérhad, to plan the invasion. This great county housed those pagans who did not support Andrew's Christian reign. Bela traveled back to Poland for only a short while, returning in the spring with a fierce Polish army on his side. Many knights had Bela trained, who now fought wearing his tabard to show their allegiance to him. The two armies met upon the field, sun shining off the armor of the grand soldiers. Loud was the clash as swords met shields echoing through the mountains. Both armies fought valiantly, yet Bela's army was stronger. King Andrew's army began withdrawing from the field. Andrew's men ran back through the vacant town. They heard behind them the stomping boots of Bela's men who were determined to capture the king. There was no escape. Andrew was captured. His men put to death. Before he was slain, King Andrew spoke to his brother. You are nothing but a knave. The crown of our forefathers will weigh heavy upon your hollow throne.